For those of us who are counting, today is the second Sunday of Advent. Two down, two to go, and we're halfway through the season of waiting, halfway to Christmas and the coming of Christ among us, as one of us, as part of us. Now, unlike the culture around us, our church is in no hurry to get there. With the wisdom of the ages, the wisdom of the centuries, our tradition tells us that it is the journey that we need just as much as arriving to that manger in Bethlehem. It tells us to pause, to take stock, and to prepare a place within our hearts so that there is room for the birth of God's Son. Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his path. St. John the Baptist quotes Isaiah. In other words, and in short, he says, make this path straight to the desert. Now, for us, it may not seem like any kind of preparation, but think about it. For someone who lived in the desert, this must have been some kind of piece of heaven where the valleys would now be filled in and the mountains and the hills would be made low. No more hard climbs, no more knee-wrenching descents, no more bandits in the valleys, no more wolves around the bends. No, Isaiah tells us that the Lord's way is flat, it's straight, and it will be totally revealed. Only the Word of God will stand, which is his way of telling us that whatever else we're attached to, it will let us down. Only God's word is forever. Only he will not let us down, because you see, on that day, all flesh will see the salvation that comes from our God. So how will we live? How will we wait? Well, in today's gospel, on this Sunday, John the Baptist appears to us as an answer to that question. Here's a man who is rough, an utterly sincere person who wears everything he owns on his back, who uses the wilderness as his pulpit, and who will preach to anyone who will listen to him, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. Well, what does this mean for us? Well, certainly it is true that most of us are waiting for something. If not for the coming of the Lord, then for the coming of something else. We're waiting for maybe finals to be over, waiting for true love, waiting for good health, waiting for a job, waiting for peace in our families or in our world, in our nation. Some of us are waiting for something, and most of us, I think, are waiting for something we can't even name what it is. Words escape us. But all we think sometimes is that there's got to be something better and more than there is right now. Isaiah and John the Baptist also lived for something they could not name. For Isaiah, it was the glory of the Lord. For John, it was for someone coming after him, someone mightier than he. They couldn't give us the exact details. In fact, John couldn't even give a name to his hearers to listen for. All that either of them could proclaim is that the old ways were passing and something new was coming in. Without the luxury of details, without any concession for our need to know or how to get ready, all they say is to make something straight and flat, remove something, and waiting without even know when it will come or what it will look like or how it will change our lives. During the time of Advent, we are asked to wait for something completely different, utterly new, that will be brought to us in person by our true and living God. It's okay if we don't have the answers to everything we're waiting for. Advent is about a time of preparing for something new. Sometimes preparing without even knowing how to wait, but just preparing with nothing, even if it's faith, hope, and love, and learning that in the stillness of that silence, we know that we live in God's mercy, yes, but it's a mercy that promises everything, a mercy that promises the birth of his Son and those who have prepared him a room.